Imagine that you've got a bullet hole, say about yay big. Self-healing has no way of approaching that problem at all. The materials that would be used to heal that hole would simply fall out, bleed out under gravity. So we've come up with a system that actually can close that entire hole completely and truly regenerate that material that's been lost because of the penetration of the bullet. Historically, when you look at self-healing materials, you're really filling in small cracks, small scale damage in an existing material. Here we don't have an existing material, it's gone. And we have to regenerate that entire material system from the ground up. What we have done is essentially mimicked the blood clotting feature that you see in humans and other biological systems, so that now the fluids don't just bleed out of the hole anymore. They're actually retained in place, and we grow on top of them until we completely seal up the damage itself. The problem here is the gravity. So we had to overcome that. And the way we overcome that is to develop a chemical system that has a gelation that happens very quickly. And that gel-like material helps in retaining it in the hole, if it's a hole, or on a surface, if it's a surface, wherever the damage is, it retains it in place so that it doesn't bleed out. So what's important about our approach chemically is that we've been able to isolate the chemical components for two separate reactions to occur simultaneously into very stable channel networks. When damage occurs, those two fluid streams come together and start to mix. Immediately, gelation occurs, but simultaneously, that gel will harden with the passage of time. In this example, you see an 8-millimeter hole, and two fluid streams are entering that hole. One we've dyed red with a fluorescent dye, and the other is actually light blue. And so you see the inner interface that develops between those fluid streams as it's pumping into the hole. It folds and folds and folds on itself, and you start to see the mixture of those two fluid streams filling up the entire hole eventually. And then at a later time, it will actually harden into a structural polymer. One of the critical features that we were able to demonstrate is that we have the ability to tune the kinetics of these reactions independently. So we can speed up the gelation reaction or slow it down. And we can speed up or slow down the hardening reaction that allows you to recover structural materials. This ability to tune the kinetics allows you to address a large number of different types of damage that might occur. For example, when something is impacted, what you find is that there may be a central hole, but there also are tiny microcracks that emanate from that hole. And if you have a material system that gels almost immediately, then there's no way to actually push the fluids into that fine network of cracks that surround the hole. So we can independently tune the kinetics to achieve healing and regeneration in a wide variety of different damage conditions. One of the most exciting things about the kind of work that we're doing right now is that I think regeneration is really just a first step towards the ultimate goal. And the ultimate goal here is to have a material system that continually generates itself anew so that it remodels. And just like the human bones are continually remodeling throughout your lifetime, you would see engineering structures that continually regenerate during their lifetime and perhaps extend their lifetime beyond even our wildest dreams at this point.